r/AskReddit. Reddit, what's your biggest fear when entering a relationship? If you want to join my giveaway for $500, subscribe and you will be automatically entered. Can I trust this person? That things I told him in confidence will no longer be kept to himself. That I'll smother someone in affection and it'll turn them off from me. I've always felt emotion strongly. And sometimes I have to rein it back. But I worry that I'll fall for someone hard and they won't have the same reaction. That you'll notice the things I'm insecure about and leave me. What if opening up to them has unforeseen long-term consequences that fuck my life or their life up? I've told someone I can't get in a relationship. I have trust issues from being cheated on. Their answer: I wouldn't do that. My response: that's what she said. I worry that I've already met and lost the love of my life, which is something I didn't believe in before I met her. I worry that I'll never value any relationship enough, as it will always feel like a consolation prize and that whoever I'm with will sense that and it will tear us apart. I crave intimacy like any human being, but fear it will cause too much pain for everyone involved. At first I feared growing apart. But then I learned to adapt and adjust to the changes without losing the connection with my loved one. People tend to grow apart in relationships. Long-term relationships are always under assault by people who want to take your partner away from you or vice versa. They wait on the sidelines and will seize on any sign of weakness in your relationship. Ignoring your wife? Well, golly gee whiz. Do I have a solution for her? The best advice to avoid losing your partner to someone else's affection is to avoid taking them for granted. If you want a long-term relationship, let them know you love them every day and show it in how you act to them. Every single day. Having to break up. That it will become abusive like my first long-term relationship. I left my abusive husband 3 months ago. So my biggest fear right now is ending up with another narcissist. I don't think I'd be strong enough to leave again. It's terrifying to think that someone could pretend to be the ideal partner for as long as they need to be. Then suddenly they're hell-bent on destroying everything about you. That they don't like me back. Even if it is only a platonic relationship. I worry every day that my friends only hang out with me because they feel bad for me. If I don't get enough attention in a relationship, then I start to panic and wonder if it's one-sided. Losing my independence and not being able to do what I want. When I want. Guess that's why I've been single for so long and don't really want a relationship. See the film. Gone Girl. And for ladies, I'd have to guess see the film. Room. That they'll find out I'm actually 3 kids stacked on top of each other under a trench coat. The other person playing me cheating on me. That happened once when I was heavily interested in a person and was wanting to move forward in our relationship. It hurt me when I found out and took a long time to get over. Being emotionally invested into something that might not work. Am I just seeing this person through rose-tinted glasses? The biggest one of all. The idea of being so comfortable with someone that you could open up and show all of the skeletons in your closet. All of the fears and doubts. And one day. Maybe not now. Maybe not later. Maybe never. That information could be used to hurt you in a way that could never happen by chance. That the woman isn't interested in me. I'm just really nice. Kind. Sweet. Charming and cute, and so she thinks she should be interested in me. It already happened, so now I'm done with relationships. Fell in love with a narcissist who was only with me because he could use me. He got addicted to drugs and I stupidly thought I could save him. He went to rehab, I went to bankruptcy court. As soon as he got sober, he ditched me for a prettier, younger girl, while still sleeping with me every Saturday while she was at work. He relapsed. She dumped him. He came back to me, I sent him to live out of state to get his shit together. He didn't, but lied and told me he had. Moved back here. Moved in with me. Died in my arms 9 months later from a car fentanyl overdose. So yeah. I'm done with relationships. Relationships require a lot of trust. And dude destroyed my ability to trust anyone but myself. That it's all a lie and she doesn't really like me. That they'll meet someone better than me. It's happened far too often and I don't know if I could ever not have that thought in the back of my mind. I'm always worried new partner, S, will find my personality, quirks, habits annoying or weird, etc. I'm always worried about being more attached or interested than the other person is. 2. I think what it boils down to is I'm just insecure. From recently read threads. My new fear is being bitten on the leg during a blowjob. Long-winded answer, but I have a skin disease that looks really gross and bad. That I'm sure can be mistaken for an STD. Before I can become intimate with anyone, I always disclose this. My biggest fear is someone rejecting me outright for this. It's happened once before and it affected me so much that I just noped out of dating for years. The biggest fear is jumping back in and having the same thing happen. How am I going to fuck this up? That it's a genuine relationship. And not an extended booty call. That it's not infatuation and a glorified honeymoon period. That she'll eventually lose interest in me. That I'll do everything I can think of to love them and then I'll still have to watch as they fall out of love with me. Because of things I should have known, you should know how I felt about this, or you should have known what people think about you, or you should have known I was only doing what you wanted. It's a really awful way to end a relationship, no cheating. Just constantly talking at each other and it feels like you're speaking different languages. How long till they poof? Always ready for people to leave me. That I'm being used. Being left with no certain reason. It was a joke or a bet. A sharp, sudden change in demeanor or attitude toward me. Making me feel like I did something wrong. I dated someone who is type 1 bipolar and for the first few months she was so fun. Was enthusiastic. Caring. Good-natured. Selfless. Etc. And suddenly she became withdrawn. Wouldn't look at me. Wouldn't smile or have anything to say. It destroyed me because I thought it was all my fault. Now I've learned not to own it personally. But it still hurts when someone's attitude changes toward you for no discernible reason. Please just don't hurt me. Guys can go through shit with relationships too and it's always kinda bugged me that a lot of people seem to not think care about that. That they don't really feel the way they say they do. Getting cheated on. Worst kind of betrayal. And statistically. It's going to happen. That I will let them down. I'm think I'm bi, male, but I'm still questioning. I know for sure that I'm into men but I'm still a bit iffy about whether I'm into women too. I haven't actually been in a relationship yet. But it's stressful because I'm not out yet so I can't really date a guy. On top of that. If I did decide to follow through and date a guy. I don't think I would feel okay doing that because I wouldn't be able to devote my full self to him. Since I'm mostly closeted, and I also don't want him to be my dirty little secret which I have to keep from my friends and family. On the other hand, if I date a woman, what happens if it actually turns out I'm gay? I don't want to pull someone into a relationship only just to put them through a breakup too. As of right now, there's a girl who I kind of like and she may feel the same towards me. But I have no clue how to approach the situation and I don't want to put her through anything that would hurt her. She's also my best friend so I have a lot to lose if things go south. Do they like me for me or were they hoping I'd change for them over time? I go all in way too quick. And end up burning myself. So I guess my fear is letting all my guard down too quick and getting hurt. Having an amazing relationship and loving each other a lot but having a fundamental incompatibility which means you don't have a future together and at some point you have to make the decision to break up despite nothing being wrong. Being cheated on again. Trusting them because my last relationship was a 3-year lie. The fear of me becoming less interested in myself over time. Missing out on something better. Getting suckered into an abusive relationship. Heartbreak. I feel like it's almost inevitable. Trust. Mainly if they're using me or going to cheat. You think people on Reddit get into relationships? If the other person is in it for genuine reasons or if they have ulterior motives. Having my time wasted. You don't find me attractive anymore? Cool. You fall out of love? Great. You want to stop communicating? Splendid. You find someone else? Fantastic. If you cannot be man or woman enough to try to fix things or simply just don't want to, that's understandable. But just don't waste my fucking time no matter how much you think it'll hurt me. Being abused again. Left a 4-year abusive relationship. That they don't really care about me. Anxiety. I lost my partner 2 weeks ago. He was 36. Just went to sleep and never woke up. No idea why. The post-mortem results won't be ready until after Christmas. So I'm going to go with the fear of losing them unexpectedly. That I go too far. Too fast. That they will get bored of me. Want something else. They will cheat on me. Or fall out of love and leave me. That eventually. She'll lose interest in me. I'm not saying I want to keep someone emotionally hostage for my sake or prevent them from following what their heart desires. I just want someone to think before they enter a relationship with me and ask themselves how much do I really like him. I want them to save us the heartache of breakup. I'd rather be rejected and stay as friends than to have someone wake up, decide that this chance isn't working out, and break up with me. That the relationship might end badly and you can't even be friends. Was bullied heavily last year and had a female classmate stand up for me. We became friends. Messaging each other every day and eventually she confessed she had feelings for me. So we started dating and broke up due to the fact I was going through some heavy personal stuff. It ended amicably. But she distanced herself more and more up to the point where we never talk. Like the other week we were assigned for project work and we just did our individual duties in silence. Like damn man. Couldn't things go back to what it once was? I'm always afraid I won't love her the way I loved my last girlfriend. I feel like my threshold for interconnectedness is shrinking. That I wake up from the dream. Cheating. That they will see me without this mask on. My wife finding out. That the tiny things that the other person does. The weird habits which you don't understand. Which seem adorable or quirky initially. Might start grating on you over time. That you'll run out of things to say one day and you will not want to know how their day went or what they're up to. Going out on dates will just be a formality because it is a familiar and convenient ritual. And you have adjusted to it now even though you don't care about meeting. That they'll realize I'm not really that great once they really get to know me. Or that they were bonked on the head and eventually will get their brains unscrambled and run for the hills. I've got some unkind thoughts about myself thanks to abuse that I'm still working through. Years later. I'm afraid that they'll lose interest or stop being attracted to me. Like and subscribe if you want to.